And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Three rounds. This is a catch weight, 162 pounds. Entering the cage first, fighting out of the blue corner. A mixed martial artist standing 5'8" tall and weighing in 158.5 pounds. As a professional, 12 bouts, 8 victories, 4 defeats from Deerfield Beach, Florida. Here is ABEL Killer Trujillo.
How y'all doing? I'm ABEL Trujillo. I'd like to thank Authentic Sports Management, Jacko, and my team, the Black Zillions, for helping me prepare for this fight. I'd like to thank CFA. This fight's gonna be boombastic. Don't miss it.
Here we go with your 10th fight of the evening, guys. Fighting out of the blue corner. Fighting out of Deerfield Beach, Florida, 28 years old, standing 5'8" tall. 8-4 professional record. ABEL Killer Trujillo.
I want to tell Frank Carrillo he's coming down to my weight class, lightweight. He fought middleweight and welterweight. This ain't what you want, man. I even make it easy on you. Let's do a catch weight, a 162. So just be ready, man, because you're gonna get that ass whooped.
And his opponent fighting out of the red corner, making his way to the cage. A mixed martial artist standing 5'7" tall. He too weighed in 158.5 pounds and brings a professional record, 5 victories and 2 defeats. Fighting out of, representing Miami, Florida, here is Frank the Tank Carrillo.
It's Frank the Tank Carrillo. Right now is more like a tiny tank. I've been cutting weight for a while. I'm coming down from 205 to 155, so this is gonna be a brand new category for me. I'm just going there. I don't know what the hell is gonna happen. I'm just gonna go in there and have some fun. And I don't know. See you Saturday, man.
His opponent fighting out of the red corner, representing Miami, Florida, 28 years old, 5'7", 5-2 professional record, Frank the Tank Carrillo.
Relax.
158.5.
158.5.
The way I predict the fight's gonna end is gonna be a big smile on my face and a big burger waiting for me at home.
We'll be right back.
Wow. This is one fight I personally have been waiting for, guys. Frank the Tank Carrillo dropping all this weight from MMA Masters. MMA Masters having an amazing night tonight.
Now, let me see if I get this correctly. Tell me if I get this correct. He was a light heavyweight?
Yes.
Yes,
Frank the Tank Carrillo, I've had the pleasure of watching training at MMA Masters. He's come down at least 40 pounds.
Holy smokes, that's a lot of weight to lose for a fight.
You got the Stunner winning, you got Cubita winning, Joey Rodriguez. Unfortunately, we weren't able to see Danny Chavez. Now we got Frank Carrillo. Boy, MMA Masters really representing tonight. Also, a lot of their amateurs. We got a kid, Evan Lynn, 17 years old, about to turn 18 in the next 2 weeks, coming out of MMA Masters.
CFA.
Coming out of MMA Masters that I'm sure the CFA is also looking at. And his dad is at home watching tonight closely the competition he's gonna be facing. And here we go, Frank the Tank Carrillo representing MMA Masters against ABEL TRUJILLO.
You know, guys, Carrillo wanted to touch gloves coming out, and Trujillo would have none of it.
Guys, I got some information on Ladir Araujo versus Luis Santos that was supposed to happen tonight. Unfortunately, CFA reached out to Canadian officials who needed to lift a suspension. However, they didn't respond back, and that's the reason why this fight will not happen tonight.
Wow.
However, CEO of CFA, George Navarro, has stated that at CFA 8, August 18th, Araujo and Santos will meet for a title.
Ah, for a title.
I will tell you this, Frank the Tank Carrillo doesn't get tired. And right now we have ABEL TRUJILLO on top of Frank the Tank. Let's see what he does from here to dominate this position. Frank Carrillo's jiu-jitsu is crazy.
That's good news, Rodolfo. What's the date on that title shot again?
Tickets are good shots
there. August 18th. And you can get your tickets by visiting, as far as information, cfafights.com.
Wow.
Already trying to go for a submission move, guys.
Tell you one thing, very, very quick start.
Whoa,
this fight. Great takedown there by ABEL TRUJILLO.
What a brutal move there by ABEL.
Nasty dump.
Yes. Got a break in his neck.
Trujillo, boy, he's monster. Like you were saying, George, Trujillo just looks big, thick, and full. He's jacked. He had a great rehydrate, obviously.
Very good rehydrate. He's definitely very strong at this weight class. We also got to see, guys, we know Frank Carrillo is predominantly a light heavyweight, has come down a lot of weight for this fight. Will it be a factor? You know, I've seen him fight. The guy is incredible.
Remember our main event, Luis Palomino versus Jaycius Calvacante, better known as Jay-Z.
Looking forward to that. I don't believe that Trujillo can maintain this pace for the remainder of the fight. I think he was going to make short work of Frank Carrillo. And if he thinks that, he's in for a long night.
What's that?
And coming up next, a lot of people have been waiting for
this
one.
Here we go.
Jordan Parsons.
Carrillo with his head movement. Big old quads on him, too.
Now, that definitely must take some toll on you as far as losing so much weight for this fight. Now, to lose such a large number there of pounds, Zen.
Great side-to-side movement there by ABEL TRUJILLO, not letting Frank Carrillo set up anything at the time.
Zen, how much of a toll does that have to lose such a large amount of weight for Frank Carrillo?
Takes a huge toll, and again, lands in the mount position here. We got ABEL TRUJILLO.
Great job of composing the guard.
One thing I can tell you about Frank Carrillo is that he is a tough opponent and works very good off his back.
Yeah, he did a really good job.
Referee James Waring looking real closely at the fight, standing them up. Very nice, back up to their feet.
Well, Abel's wrestling, dominating Carrillo. powerful.
Trujillo, the four-time NAIA All-American, aggressive style.
I'll tell you one thing. Carrillo coming off a nice knockout victory against his opponent over in Bellator with an uppercut. You know, he's definitely can end the fight at any time. I would not get impatient if I was ABEL Trujillo.
ABEL Trujillo dedicating this fight to the Black Zillions. He is so excited to be a part.
Wow, it's that capoeira kick there by Carrillo.
Wow.
Goes for a single. If he sweeps that leg, he'll bring him up backwards. Let's see if he's able to do him. He's bringing him up to the cage. Perfect.
Very common from an MMA master.
Listening to his corner, he's got a single leg here. High single he's got. Frank Carrillo keeping his composure here. He's taken down.
Wow, Trujillo taking advantage with his flurry of punches.
Very good round for Trujillo to start this fight off at 160. A dominant round, frankly, for Trujillo. But Carrillo doing a good job in there. But this is the question you asked at the beginning of the fight, and that is, how much did that 40-pound cut affect Carrillo?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. You got ABEL Trujillo standing up. He says, I don't want the chair. I'm not tired. I want to stand here. I don't care. Take the stool back, he told his corner. So, wow. Definitely an exciting fight here. I think Frank Carrillo was very overwhelmed by the explosiveness of ABEL Trujillo that first round. Wasn't expecting him to come out that fast and that fast pace. His corner screaming to him, don't worry, he's going to tire out. But unfortunately, ABEL Trujillo has not. Getting some last minute slaps there by his corner.
Remember, guys, follow the action. We want to hear from you. What did you think about that last round? Hashtag CFA Fights 07 on Twitter. Follow also on Instagram at CFA Fights.
Yeah, I don't know what Trujillo walks around at, but I guarantee it's not 205. He had a much easier cut. Much easier cut. There's no two ways around it.
You can see on Carrillo's thorax, much larger than Abel's.
Well, you have to understand, if you obviously a lot more bigger bone person, Frank Carrillo. If you look at the chest to back thickness of Carrillo versus ABEL Trujillo, is a way bigger man. But if you look at the shoulder span of Trujillo, he carries that 160 beautifully. I'll tell you that much.
Now, we got to remember here, he weighed in at a certain weight last night, but how much is Carrillo weighing tonight? To be an advantage to him.
Yeah, Carrillo weighed in at 158, I believe, yesterday in the weigh-ins.
So he must be easily.
Nice leg kick there by Frank Carrillo.
More than 5 pounds heavier today.
I'd like to see more of those leg kicks. That's a good way of keeping Trujillo honest. Frank Carrillo at 5-2 out of MMA Masters, 28 years old. They call him the Tank.
He's got his hands kind of low, keeps getting caught with that left hook.
Abel looking at his prey.
He's got to be careful with that left hook. He's going in for that shoot, gets it stuffed. Now I'll tell you one thing, he's got a body lock here on Trujillo. If he's able to bring his opponent down, I'd like to see what Frank Carrillo can do off top position.
Denny Morris says that the weight loss looks like it's hurting the Tank.
Bringing his knee in, trying to sweep that back leg, still with a body lock.
James Waring warning Carrillo to get active, do something with it.
He's trying to sneak that right hand in so he can get that body lock. There he goes.
kind of slow down the pace of the fight, guys.
Yeah, he's got to hook that right leg over Trujillo's left so he can scoop. Now he's got it. Definitely from there, he's got it.
Carrillo definitely using that weight to his advantage, trying to see if he gets some sort of slam on Abel.
Very, very, very strong. Abel Trujillo controlling the takedown of Frank Carrillo. Great takedown defense here by ABEL Trujillo.
It was an interesting what Carrillo said at the press conference. He said, you know, frankly, I really have no idea what's going to happen in there. I don't think that he's lost this kind of weight, at least for a long time, to go into a fight. And he really wasn't sure what kind of gas tank he'd have. So far, he's been okay.
Nice left hook there. Well, I'll tell you one thing, if he's able to sink in this.
Abel trying to see if he brings down the tank.
Oh, he's going maybe for a darts choke here. Let me tell you, this is a specialty at MMA Masters. If he can sink it in,
and he
he's
got
that choke in.
Well, Abel made quick of that escape. Carrillo has Trujillo cornered on that cage.
I'm telling you, guys got to be careful with Frank the Tank Carrillo. This guy has cardio for days. He's very poised. He's a comeback kid. If he tires out Trujillo in these later rounds, I'm telling you, it's going to be a long night for him. Again, trying to work that single.
I want to refresh people's mind that Trujillo last had a controversial fight last time here at CFA with an early stoppage.
Yes, against Edson Berto. Crowd wasn't too happy with that.
Oh, and there's that.
Brings him down to the ground. I'm telling you right now, he's excellent in jiu-jitsu if he's able to sink in his hooks. Oh, back to the top.
Well, you know, by here you would see Trujillo's top offense, which would be wrestling, but Carrillo not quitting and trying to get that takedown on the ground, and then hopefully working that jiu-jitsu skill he has.
Telling you right now.
Carrillo's done a good job of stopping the momentum.
Nice right hook there by Frank.
Wow. Connecting.
And he hurt
Trujillo.
His opponent, and he felt it. Elbow Trujillo coming back. Nice straight right there by Trujillo.
Want to go for a knee there, flying
missed
knee.
Mark. Nice flying knee attempt there. 10 seconds left.
Oh. Another capoeira kick attempt.
Nice straight right hand, kind of rocks Abel Trujillo. Wow, that's a nice finishing round there for Frank Carrillo. Could this be a turnaround factor? Will Trujillo take a seat now?
I got it dead even, guys.
Melvin Gillard now here at the corner of Abel Trujillo.
Oh, I think that this pace of the fight is changing here. I see the MMA Masters corner hyping up Frank the Tank Carrillo. I think that he thinks he can win this fight now.
Well, in a much better round, you know, clearly Trujillo won the first round. But boy, he stopped all that momentum in the second round and had a real nice dominant performance. He was on top of him for the majority of the round and had that strong finish as well, hurting Trujillo.
And our lovely CFA ring girls.
Hey guys, remember, follow us on Twitter at CFA Fights, hashtag CFA Fights 07, on Instagram at CFA Fights, and visit the website TFAFights.com for all the latest information and news on the number one promotion in Florida, CFA. Melvin Gillard yelling at Elbow Trujillo, now you got him.
This can be a real good round because I think both of these fighters have to know they've got to win this round. and oh, they've got to win this round. If their corners are earning their money tonight, they will have told them, you've got to win this round.
Frank Carrillo's corner telling him he's tired to press the fight.
You know, Abel did a little bit gassed out there in that last round.
Abel Trujillo's corner saying, make him fight, he's tired. He's got to be careful with that right hand. He still has that left hand low.
Another attempt there at a flying knee. Oh, kind of a sloppy
there.
These
guys are swinging for the fences, yes. Frank the Tank took a slip here on the side of the cage. Left hook was blocked by Frank. Straight right hand did catch.
A 1-2 punch there by Abel connecting.
Both these guys are very wet, hence the
nice counter punch there by Trujillo.
Takedowns.
Telling Abel him to take the chin down. Beautiful left
another
hook, straight
yep.
right.
He's definitely connected when he hits. Abel Trujillo now trying to search, target a right spot where to connect.
Ooh, overhand right there by Frank the Tank Carrillo off of a counter. He's letting his hands fly now. Backing Trujillo up. Nice, brings him down there next to his corner. Abel Trujillo is able to reverse it, trying to take the back of Frank the Tank Carrillo. Wow, this is just an absolute war. Frank is going for a leg there, Jay.
Great scramble between both of these guys. Back and forth action.
Going for a leg there, Jay. Will he be working his jits?
This fight is so close. Anything that happens here in the final 3 minutes could win this fight.
Wow, we were talking about fight of the night before, but let me tell you guys, these guys are banging it out too. Great, great night of action here at the Bank United. Overhand right attempt there by Frank Carrillo just barely misses Abel Trujillo that's backing up now. I think Frank Carrillo sees that his opponent is backing up. His corner screaming at him, he's getting tired.
Well, everything must go now. Carrillo not trying to leave it to the judge's hands, looking for a submission.
He's got the guard closed up. If he can compose the guillotine.
2 minutes left here in this third and final round.
Looking for that guillotine, trying to close up the guard now. Great back and forth battle here.
And he reverses it. Now we see a nice little cut there on the eye of Frank Carrillo. Will that be impeding his vision? Referee looking closely.
Carrillo bleeding on that right eye, from what I can tell, guys.
Yes, from that right eye right now. I'm just wondering if it's obstructing his vision at the time.
He sinks in
that guillotine again. Is it strong enough with the posturing up of Abel Trujillo?
He has his legs wrapped around him.
Is he able to actually sink it in there?
He's got plenty of time to work it. Minute to go here in the final round.
He's sinking it in tight.
Well, he let go of it now.
He lets go of that right arm, so he definitely doesn't have it. Abel Trujillo with his shoulder up against Frank Carrillo's face on that cage door. I don't think he'll be able to submit from that position. Very, very smart game plan there by Abel Trujillo.
Getting close to 30 seconds left in this final round of nonstop action between Trujillo and Carrillo. Corner of Trujillo telling him to attack, to get that W here tonight at CFA 7.
Goes for an arm bar.
Don't waste time is what Trujillo's corner is telling him. And clearly Trujillo has that advantage of listening to his corner since he's right next to it.
Absolutely. Well, I'll tell you, there's a couple of seconds left here in this last round. And from the looks of it, guys, Abel Trujillo's definitely leaving it in the hands of the judges.
How did you score this one, guys? Hashtag CFA Fight 07. Who won, Trujillo or Carrillo? Guys,
I got Trujillo winning 2-1.
I got Trujillo 2-1 as well.
Same here. Mac United Center showing their support for Abel Trujillo.
Judges have done a fabulous job tonight, I think, on all of the scoring. I've been very accurate tonight. Your judges tonight, Rich Green, Rick Bays, Mark Streisand, and Alicio Rodriguez. I think they've done a great job tonight.
There we see the MMA Masters corner, Vlagia, Bebe Monstro Araujo, that was supposed to fight tonight. We were very much looking forward to that fight.
Again, he will be fighting Luis Santos at CFA 8, August 18th.
And this will
for
be
a title
fight, correct?
It will be for a title fight. That's what CEO of CFA, Jordan Alavan, has stated.
These guys get so disappointed. They put so much into getting ready for a fight. To have it pulled at the last minute, it's just devastating.
I agree. Again, while we wait for Joe Martinez and the official decision, we'd like to thank our sponsors, Jackal Clothing and Apparel, Miccosukee Resort and Gaming Office, Max, Sergio's Printing, Fernandez Dental, G-War, La Coronela, and fans.com.
Carrillo, Abel Trujillo.
Here you go with the official word.
Come on over here, my friend.
All right, I'm here with the winner, Abel Trujillo, who's giving out some major, some shouts there. That felt good, didn't it?
Hell yeah.
You knew you had a very tough opponent in Frank Carrillo. You knew this was a huge test for you. And if you could come up with this win, it really puts you in the mix. Your thoughts on your performance tonight?
You know, I was pleased. I came out in the first round. I thought I had him damaged, so I kind of went all out because I was going for the kill, but it all worked out.
When you knew that he had to make a 40-pound weight cut, is that what said, you know what, if I can take him out in the first round, you know, maybe I can gas him out? Was that the strategy?
That's my strategy in any fight, is to finish the first round, but I knew if it went on to the second and third, the weight cut would wear on him.
Well, you did a great job in there. You're back in the mix. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Woo! Abel Trujillo! I'm just a little bit.
Abel Trujillo taking home the victory with an extremely, extremely tough opponent in Frank Carrillo.
That's a good fight. Good fight.
I'm sure Frank will be back.
How about that one before that?
And now, Zen, the moment we've been waiting for. A lot of people have been tweeting about this. And on Facebook, Jordan Parsons versus Azar.
These guys are going to have to work to take
on
those guys.
So, Janodinovic.
The Janodinovic.
Yes.
CFA.